you. His mother told him someday you will be a man, and you will be the leader of a big old band. Many people coming from miles around to hear you play your music when the... Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I suppose you're wondering what happened to Tony. Well, if for those of you people who were out of the country last week, we had Tony here. He finally did a segment on the show because everybody wanted more of Tony. So he volunteered with a Dr. Smartenheine. And this guy was a brain surgeon who did remove Tony's brain, who did promise to get it back into his head. And we thought the guy was legit. He did do some surgery on the head, and everything seemed to be okay for a while until he started cracking jokes about the brain. And then he started drinking some of the alcohol that the brain was in. And when they dropped his head on the floor, that's when I knew we were in trouble. Also, he had some twisted blonde with him. Now we don't know whether she was an accomplice or an assistant or just what was going on.
Tony, okay?
Well, we're not sure right now. We have a place. We're going to be sending him away at the end of the show. In fact, he's going to be leaving in a little while, so they're getting him ready. He's got some nurses. We also have a detective here this evening that is looking for Dr. Smartenheine, and he promises to find him. A little later on in the show, we have Mr. Johnson. He's charge of product development here at the Mike and Tony Show, and he has some products for us. And also, we have a up-and-coming comedian, a great comedian. His name is Kevin what?
Kevin Graham.
Kevin Graham. Oh, how I forget that name. I'll probably never forget it again, but anyway, thanks, Kevin. Kevin Graham will be on in a little while. He's a real funny guy. Anyway, we're hoping the best for Tony, and we're going to be sending him out in a little while. So be with us, and we're going to be right back with Kevin Graham. Thank you.
Driving just 5 miles per hour slower than we usually do will save over 2 million gallons of gas a day and help keep America out of the red. Do your part. Drive smart.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Graham. Big hand for Kevin.
I am so glad you chose me this evening. I'll accept this Oscar in behalf of Mike, who's beautiful. How you doing, Mike? I love your beer. I love your cigar. Don't smoke. It's not good for you, man.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. How are you doing?
Yeah. Everyone in the back, you having fun?
Yeah!
Okay, bear with me, okay? Because I'm not your regular comedian, okay? First of all, I'm not from this country, so I am Scottish. I'm not English. I'm not Irish. I'm not Russian. I don't talk like this. I am not coming here to take over your country or nothing, okay? I am just Kevin Graham.
Kevin
Is that how you put it? Kevin
Graham.
Kevin Graham. All right. It's about like Bond, but Kevin Graham. Hi, I can't see nobody. How you doing? Okay, bear with me. You can cut this out and come back to it, okay? If you want.
have to stop clapping just because the beat doesn't fit you.
I'm sorry, we white people, we gotta do other stuff. I'm kidding.
Kill Whitey, get him off the stage.
I'm kidding. No, I'm not. I'm having fun. This is a funny stage. All the people are way back over there. Hello. Yeah, we have a big audience tonight, everybody. We're all having fun. Okay, I wouldn't say that then. If I keep moving, can you stay with me? Hey, how you doing? Here we are, 5-5, the number one cam in the world. The world of the football is back again. It's the second season. Nobody is winning. The Giants are winning. The Jets are winning. They're in New Jersey, but they're called New York. What's your problem? I don't understand. I'm a Scotsman. We play soccer. We don't play football. That's why we have so much violence. Yes! Violence! Ah! I love New York City. Isn't that a great place? New York City. Yeah! Jersey! New York City is awesome! I dubbed that myself for you audience. Yeah, kitties watching? Channel 69. Swastle on Noof, it's fun. I don't know. Shut up. Don't laugh. It's not funny. It's just not funny. I'm sweating. It must be the lights. Can I get a tan off of these? Can I? I'm getting a rash. I know that, Mike. Yeah, shut up. I know. How's life? So, tell me. Can I interview you?
Sure.
Yeah. Why do you smoke cigars, Mike?
Like,
is that like a... This is actually your homosexual channel. Tony and Mike are actually lovers. If he doesn't have it in there, he's got a cigar. As simple as that. I'm kidding. He's a beautiful man. And it's not a toupee! It's not a toupee! He will be famous. Is there any females in the audience? There is no audience. Let's move over here to Harvey's table. Harvey, say hello to the audience, Harvey. Mary, I'll mourn ya. I'm gonna mourn ya, Mary. Wouldn't that be good if they did that? Instead of, you know, every year, the same old thing. They put it on cable. It's a wonderful life. Jimmy Stewart mooning Mary every time he sees her or something. You know? Escape from Bellevue again, Mary. I'll never get your mom. No pictures, please. I don't know. I get a lot of fun here. I've noticed it's not just English that you have to speak when you come to America, especially in taxis in Jersey. I mean, I was in the other day and the guy's in, he's, and I looked at him and I went, $4.99. What region are you from? I said, I come from back over there in Egypt, oh, you know, all people listening to me. He loved it. He said, but you're white, you don't talk funny. You have smelly breath though. Smelly breath like brother. Smelly breath like sister. What are you talking about? I don't know. It's like you have an audience, you can work off it, you know, you can... Just a camera. So what do you do when you have an orgasm? Okay. You've got to walk like this, haven't you? All comedians walk about the stage like this. It's severe depression. Keeps them walking around like, man. I got to walk around because I got to think. When you got to think of something, you don't know what to say. You got to say something, you know. You got to go out there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, should I tell you a joke?
Yeah!
Get the out of here. No! Don't be telling me jokes, please. Drive, cab. Drive away. Drive home. Go back to New York. Go home. Go back to England. I've noticed one thing about people over here in America, that when they hear that I speak English and I'm from a foreign country, they like to tell me all the problems about people coming into the country that they don't like, and the wetbacks and everything else, you know, because I can speak the language, you know. You go up to somebody and you go, I don't like you people coming over here from Mexico and stuff. Get the back over there. I don't need you here. Orale, bro, ¿qué pasó? Tú sabes siempre. They don't know what you're saying. They don't know what you're saying. You can't have an argument. You can't really get your point across. But being from Scotland and being a foreigner, hey, it's easy. You can understand me. You're going to listen to me for the next 30 minutes. Yeah, I spent some time down south. They told me I talk funny. Start talking like that. Yo, man, you got an accent. Where are you from? I got an accent. Yeah, I got an egg. Swallow. Excuse me. I'm kidding. I like homosexuals. They're okay. As long as they stay over there. Don't touch me. Don't chat me up. When I say I'm not homosexual and I'm a single person, leave me alone. You ever find out in the West Village or go down to West? No, I'm straight. Oh, come on. You really want to do it. You really do. No, I don't. And there's a lot of... Well, I'm not sure about this bunch, but there's a lot of males out there who feel the same way. We're not picking on people that are gay, are we? We're just standing up for being heterosexual males. For being a white man. Uh-oh. Shut up, Kevin. He's off again.
That was dubbed for you. That's all the question you got to be asking yourself. Is this a real-life TV show? Or are you just...
You'll get that next week. I don't know. I love these lights. I really do. I don't know. Whistle while you work. I feel like a jerk. Yeah, that's what I do. Yeah.
Drive fast in Jersey. Yeah, they do.
55 miles an hour, man. What's your problem?
It's gone up to 65, isn't it? 65 miles an hour. In Germany, you can drive down the road fast as you want. In Britain, it's basically the same thing. Saudi Arabia, basically the same thing, except you got bombs coming after you at the same time. And America, land of the free and the home of the brave! 55 miles an hour. 65 on the highway. 65 miles an hour! Jeez, 10 speeds are moving faster these days. You got a ticket on 10 speeds, you go down a hill. Isn't that true? Isn't that true? Get the off the stage, Kev. I've had enough. They had enough of your little antics.
Peace and love and have fun, and maybe one day when there's an audience, maybe one day there'll be a comedian. Love y'all.
Come on, Kevin, sit down. All that smoke is getting to you, huh? Tell me now, Kevin, where are you from? Where are you from and why do you talk like that? Want another puff?
I'm kidding. Where are I from?
Yeah, where are you from, Brooklyn?
Scotland. Claybank, Glasgow.
Scotland.
It's a fun place. We wear dresses. We're all transvestites. That's why we talk funny.
You
it's
wear
fun,
the,
though.
The
and we have big hairy spottings on the front where we keep our money. That's in case anybody steals our money. We get fun out of it as well. And it's true. Keep your money down your pouch. Here, somebody's going to steal it. You're going to get some enjoyment. Come on.
Do they wear those skirts over there?
Yeah.
Called... Just for holidays or just...
Well, it depends what you're doing on a Saturday night. Women love them. Women, honestly, easy access.
Do the girls wear skirts as well?
Yes, but they're a bit longer. They're beyond the knee. Men's are above the knee, which is actually quite.
And how long have you been in the country?
Are you INS, IRS, well, FBI, MI5? Shit, Lily White, crack ahead.
So how long have you been here?
I've been here 8 years now.
8 years? You still
I have traveled
like
America. Oh, you start talking all the time. James Griffin's in here, my Bob. How you doing? All right, we got some of the people I know. I'm there. Oh, jeez.
And where you living in Brooklyn?
That's Glasgow. We talk like that in Glasgow.
Oh, stuff. Glasgow.
Yeah. No, I live in Manhattan. Bless you. I live in Manhattan. I've been living it. I love Manhattan. It's fantastic. It's the greatest city in the world.
How about West New York?
Why?
How about West New York?
West New York? Is Cuban, isn't
second,
it?
Second
Cuban?
Place?
Cuban?
Orale, bro! We got auto parts for you. They don't work. Cuban auto parts. Remember, Dina?
Dina Bruno, one of the greatest comedians in the world, will be live on HBO maybe sometime in the future. I have no idea.
Well,
so's Mike.
We're going to go now, and I want to thank you for coming down.
God bless you. Thanks for having me.
People can see Kevin Graham, right? Most any place. Most every place.
He's good at
thank
that.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to be right back. Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you.
Go for free tickets to our show. Just write The Mike and Tony Show, 6701 Bergen Line Avenue, West New York, New Jersey, 07093. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. My next guest we have here tonight, Mr. Johnson. I understand he's got a PhD. Mr. Johnson, come right out here. John is in charge of product development here at The Mike and Tony Show. John, what do you have for us?
Mike and Tony water.
Okay, this is the Mike and Tony water that John has developed for us, and you do have a PhD. Where did you get that?
Harvard.
Harvard University?
Yeah.
This Mike and Tony water, it is so pure, it's actually got a blue tint to it, and the price of this water is $1.50. It's worth every penny of it. Now, with this water, If you sign a paper with your address, since we get charged for sewerage here, you sign a paper with your name and address, it only costs 50 cents for this water. And let the sewer company worry about where it's coming out. So come right down here now. Once you buy, it's a one-time buy, one-time purchase, you can come down to the Mike and Tony Show and you can fill this up in our own laboratories. Men's. We have a men laboratory and a female laboratory, so you can fill it up yourself. So that's the Mike and Tony water, $1.50. You going to have some other developments for us next week?
Yes, next week we'll be doing, I think, the Mike and Tony bubblegum.
Mike and Tony bubblegum. And I chew that myself, and that's going to be a very good product. So, Mr. Johnson, Dr. Johnson, thank you very much. And we're looking forward to what you bring out next week. Thank you
okay.
very much.
Sampras comes up to serve. Jan Stevenson makes the drive. A.C. Green and Charles Smith pound the boards. Marcus Allen rushes up the middle. Jay Schrader with the touchdown. There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Okay, we also have some information for people coming from the Vietnam Veterans, Chapter 151 out of Bayonne, New Jersey. We have for them on September 16th, 17th, and 18th, we have stand down at Roosevelt Park in Menlo Park, New Jersey. Also, September 18th, Rolling Thunder in New York Library State Park at 10 a.m. It's for the POWs. On September 24th, we have PTSD reunion at the Lions VA Hospital. And in September 27th, general membership meeting at the Catholic War Veterans Post 1612, 18 West 23rd Street in Bayonne. This is the first chapter of every month, non-smoking meeting. Also on October 6th, we have the hospital committee to visit East Orange Hospital. If you want to go down and go with them for the hospital, please don't hesitate to call for more information. Also on October 13th, the hospital committee is going to the Lions Hospital. And October 22nd, the Chapter 151 is having their Halloween dinner dance at the Knights of Columbus. And on October 25th, they're having a general membership meeting at the Catholics War Veterans Post 1612. That's at 18 West 23rd Street in Bayonne, New Jersey. For more information on the chapter, just call area code 201-823-1823. Or you can fax them at 201-460-3917. We also have a reunion for Union Hill High School. And you can call anyone that graduated in 1968 at Union Hill. You can call Carol, what's her name? Carol DeMilio at 864-7459. Or Jerry Catino at 867-7881. Now, for further information, we have, wait a second, we have him here somewhere. Richfield Park Elks Club, Saturday, September 17th. Sports night, it's a fundraiser. There is a donation at the door. Entertainment and food, casual dress. Also at Richfield Park, St. Francis Church, celebrating their feast day with their annual carnival, September 30th, October 1st, and 2nd. Also, St. Francis will be having an international buffet Saturday, October 2nd, of which we will let you know more information about next week. And anyone has anything, a nonprofit organization, we'll be glad to announce it here at the Mike and Tony Show. And also, we will be announcing birthdays. For the month of September, well, I know there's a birthday next week, September 19th. It's a Monday. It's my birthday. And it's also September 22nd. It's Tony's birthday. And we have Brother Eddie's birthday on October 20, 7th or 2nd or something. We'll update that as we go along. Anybody else who has a birthday, for those of you people who are born, just give us a call. And we also have our own Halloween party on the 28th of October. It's going to be an all-blowout, huge party. It's an extravaganza, so please write. You can write a letter here to 6701 Bergen Line Avenue in West New York, area code 07093. If I remember that right, yeah, 07093. So please write or come down any Monday night to see the show. Thank you very much. I got to go. Bye-bye now. Thank you.
Thanks for watching the Mike and Tony Show. For free tickets to our show, just write the Mike and Tony Show, 6701 Bergen Line Avenue, West New York, New Jersey, 07093.
Thank you. Now, my next guest is an inspector, and he's going to be working on Tony's case. So I'd like you to welcome Inspector Stratvarius. Stratvarius?
Excuse me.
Sit down. Mike Tedesco, have
Mike.
A seat.
Mike. Hello.
Now, Inspector, you are looking for Dr. Martin Heine, is that correct?
Yes, I am.
And you have, I know you brought some pictures here with you to show the people what was going on at that time.
Yes, this is Dr. Martin Heine, last seen at the Mike and Tony Show, if you can get a nice view of that.
And what, now, is it true that we don't know if that blonde was an accomplice or just what her role was?
It's possible.
It is possible.
And bit now, of a fluff, it's possible.
Now, you're going to escort Tony and the nurse to the airport. Where are they going now from here tonight?
They're leaving for Heathrow Airport in England.
And they're going to be met by
an accomplice of mine.
And I understand he's got a code name. What is the code name? Can you tell us the code name?
Screaming Eagle.
Screaming Eagle. Screaming Eagle is going to meet Tony and the nurse at Heathrow Airport in England, and then they're going on to, where were they going?
Vienna.
Vienna, where they're going to straighten Tony's head out. Also, we have an artist's rendition of...
Yes, we do. We have an artist's rendition of the doctor.
Without his glasses and
without
his...
Without his glasses and his medical garb. If you can get a nice shot of that.
You won.
That's the last time he was seen. This is what he looked like.
Now, you got posters all over town.
All over town.
And you've sent them out to Interpol?
Interpol, Scotland Yards,
now,
the UN.
Strat was also with Interpol for many years.
About 20 years ago.
And Scotland Yard as well. Correct?
Scotland Yards.
All right, so this is the guy here that we're worried about. This is the guy, if anybody sees him, now this is only an artist's rendition of what he would look like. Strat, you have anything that...
Yes, I'd like to say, be on the lookout worldwide, in town, everywhere, on the avenue, for the doctor. I want you to notice the beady eyes and the very repressed lips. And the very bushy Brezhnev eyebrows. By the way, Mike, that's a lovely tie you got there.
Well, thank you very much. Now, listen, is that a tan you have, or is this tell the people about your disguises? I mean, you can be almost anywhere at any time. He has more disguises. Is this correct?
Correct. Very correct. Actually, I haven't got a tan. It's a little bit of fallout, but...
Fallout. Okay, well, now, we're going to bring Tony out in a few minutes, and
yes,
you're going to escort them to the airport. Is that correct?
Yes, we are.
Okay, so we're going to be right back with Tony. Thank you.
So how's your cousin's new car?
Oh, yeah, my cousin's new car.
Yeah.
He picked it up last week.
All right.
Big celebration.
Yeah?
And I felt like a jerk telling him he should take a taxi home because he had one too many.
But you did.
No. I didn't.
What happened?
Totaled.
What?
Yeah, and him with it.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Take the keys. Call a cab. Take a stand. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
doesn't scare you. Just wait.
The doctor will see you now.
One night a year ago, Vanessa got high with some guy and forgot everything she learned about preventing AIDS. Now her life is the horror show. AIDS, another way drugs can kill.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Here we are with the detective and Tony's nurses, and of course we have Tony here. And where are you going from here?
Off to Heathrow.
Okay, now just let me get the names of these nurses, and your name?
Denise. Mary Ellen.
Mary.
Okay, so Tony is going to, I'm just going to give him some cigars here to take with him on the plane. And they'll be, well, wait a minute. He doesn't need all these cigars. I will save a few for myself. And Strat, you're going to take care of Tony and make sure that him and the girls arrive there safe. And okay, ladies and gentlemen, they're all right.
Good.
They're off to Heathrow. Give them a big hand, please. Thank you. Come on, nurse, you right ahead. Go ahead, take Tony right out. Good luck, Tony. We hope all the best to you.
Research indicates we Americans create too much garbage. So I have spent years developing worms that eat garbage at astonishing rates. Some eat more than others.
There's an easier way to save the world. Recycle. To find out more, dial 1-800-CALL-EDF.
Thanks for watching the Mike and Tony Show. For free tickets to our show, just write The Mike and Tony Show, 6701 Bergen Line Avenue, West New York, New Jersey, 07093. Thanks for coming, and we'll see you once again next week on The Mike and Tony Show.
Tonight, Dolores had a few drinks, did some crack, and ended up another tragic story. Only she doesn't know it yet. Drugs make you forget. And if you forget how risky sex can be, you could catch the AIDS virus. AIDS, another way drugs can kill.
Thank you for coming down to the Mike and Tony Show. We're going to see you next week, and hopefully we'll have Tony back by then. Thank you all very much. See you next week. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.